Let's go through the steps for setting up the ExpressVPN app for routers. This tutorial is for users who want to learn how to set up ExpressVPN on a Linksys router. Users who would rather purchase a pre-configured router should follow the link on the screen. The setup process will follow four main steps. First, we'll download the ExpressVPN app for routers firmware on our desktop. Second, we'll physically assemble the router. Third, we'll load the firmware onto the router, a process called flashing. Fourth, we'll connect the router to the internet through ExpressVPN. Before you begin, make sure you have the necessary components. You'll need a computer with an Ethernet port, an ExpressVPN subscription, a compatible router, and an internet connection. For this demo, we'll be working with a Linksys WRT-1200AC. You can visit the ExpressVPN support pages for a full list of compatible routers. Let's start by downloading the ExpressVPN app for routers. Log into your ExpressVPN account and click the button that says Setup ExpressVPN. On the left side of the download page, click on the Router section. Next, select your hardware model on the right. In this case, we'll pick Linksys WRT-1200AC, then click Download Firmware. Note that you must have the correct firmware for your router model. This is because flashing the wrong firmware could permanently damage your router. Do not continue until you've ensured you downloaded the correct firmware for your router model. While on the download page, you'll also want to copy your activation code to your clipboard. Simply click the copy button. You will need it for later in the setup process. Now it's time to open your router box. Inside, you should see a router manual and a CD-ROM, an Ethernet cable, two antennas, and a power adapter with socket heads for different regions. To assemble your router, screw on the two antennas. They attach on the back of the router. Next, plug the power adapter into a power source and connect it to your router. To turn it on, press the power toggle button on the back of the router so the lined end is leaning in. To flash your router, you will need to connect to your computer. Plug one end of the Ethernet cable into one of the blue ports on the back of the router. Do not plug it into the yellow port. There's no need to connect the router to the internet at this stage. Plug the other end of the cable into your computer's Ethernet port or adapter. On your computer, make sure Wi-Fi is turned off. This is to make sure the only connection is through your router via the Ethernet cable. Open a web browser window. You won't be able to access the web, but you will be able to access sites already hosted on your router. Go to the site linksyssmartwifi.com. The first screen should give you two lines to check. I have read and accepted the license terms for using this software, and I want to skip setup and configure my router manually. Ensure both boxes are checked before clicking Next. You will then see a screen telling you your internet connection is down. This is expected, as neither your router nor your computer is connected to the web. Click Login. On the next screen, type the word Admin. You should see a series of menus. Click on Connectivity under the heading Router Settings. On the right side of the screen, you should see a box where you can manually select a file to use as the router's firmware. Click on Choose File and select the file you downloaded from the ExpressVPN website. After that, click Start. You will then see a warning message telling you the firmware update will require your router to reboot. Click Yes. Once the firmware has successfully installed, click OK to reboot your router. After the router has rebooted, it will automatically redirect you to expressvpnrouter.com. You will see an authorization required screen. For the username, type in admin. The password is the 8-digit number on the bottom of the router, above the router's wireless network name. You will now have access to the ExpressVPN app for Router's user interface. However, as the page will remind you, you still do not have access to the internet. At this point, you can connect your router to your current modem or router. Remove the Ethernet cable from your computer's Ethernet port. A message will flash on your screen saying you are no longer connected to the ExpressVPN router. This is normal. You will be connected again soon. Meanwhile, remove the other end from the router's numbered blue port and plug it into the yellow Internet port. Then plug the other end into one of the ports on your current modem or router. Your router should now be connected to the Internet. On your computer, re-enable Wi-Fi and select your router from the list. If you need help figuring out which router to select, check the sticker on the bottom of the router and look for Wireless Network. You will be prompted for a password. You should find it on the bottom of the router with the label Wireless Password. Once you connect to your router wirelessly, the previous warning message should go away. You will now be on a screen where you can paste the ExpressVPN activation code you copied earlier. Note that you can access the web through your router if you press the button Enable Internet without VPN. If you no longer have the activation code copied, simply log back into your ExpressVPN account and click the Setup button to find it again. Once you activate the app for routers, ExpressVPN will automatically connect you to a VPN server using its smart location algorithm. If you want to connect to a different server, simply click Select Another Location. Congratulations! Now that your router is connected, you're all set up to enjoy a safe and secure internet connection on all the devices you connect to your VPN-protected router. You can browse, stream, game, whatever you want, with peace of mind. If you have any questions, ExpressVPN live chat support is available 24/7. Thanks for watching.